Hi, I'm Marcus with the IndieMusicLab.com. Welcome back to another episode of the What We Can Learn From series, where we just kind of casually listen to a song and see what we can learn from it. So today we are taking a look at the song Out of Time by The Weeknd. This is a cool 80s throwback kind of vibe to it. It's really cool. So let's have a listen. Okay, so the main chord progression that is happening pretty much throughout this song is a 2 minor, 3 minor, to the 6 minor. Now, I say this, again, in context of the relative major key. That's always how I think, that's how I teach. I think it's the best way to keep things simple and consistent. So, we're technically here, which means we would be in the key of E flat major slash C minor. But again, in numbers-wise, I'm thinking context, E flat major, so that gives us the 2, which is an F minor, the 3 minor, which is the G minor, up to the 6 minor, which is the C minor, in the key of E flat major. So. The last few months I've been working on me, baby. There's so much trauma in my life. I've been so cold. Now, he does kind of, I think, alternate in this song between start having it be 2 minor versus having it be the 4 major. And the reason you can do that is because the 2 minor and the 4 major are relative to each other. Or the G sharp major, rather. So it's G sharp major and F minor are... F minor is the relative minor chord to G sharp major. So those are interchangeable, and you can even switch it up as they do throughout this song. To the ones who love me, baby. So you could also think of the main chord progression as being 4 to 3 minor to 6 minor, right? 4, 3 minor, 6 minor. I look back now and I realize. Now that's really cool what they do there. It's very subtle, but notice how it's just this little dropout. Things just drop out for a second. Those little moments like that that just allow you to breathe are so overlooked and so underrated because it's so easy to forget about making sure that we're adding some nice space in our songs that allow you to breathe for a second. So that's really cool. So there he adds in that harmony vocal. Actually, it's not a harmony, it's an octave. Classic Michael Jackson there where you like rises on the pitch, so he builds the tension and goes up in pitch and like shouts out that top note, and that's a classic. And then with the little ha, ha, at the end, just classic Michael Jackson style. Still the exact same chord progression. You hear that little synth little, patch? If you mess up just a little, baby, you know here. My line. It's just these little call and response things, right? So it's in between the vocal phrase that you just add these little ear candy qualities to it. It's cool. Trust them a little, they come right back, girl, come right back. Give me one chance, just a little. Also, notice how there's not a ton of like high frequency information and like synths and everything going on, especially in the verse here. It's more that warm, slightly filtered out sound, which really makes it much easier when you have that, where it's more minimal because it allows you to let the vocal be the main focus, and then it allows you to really add in those ear candy hits and those elements and those little melodies between those vocal phrases. Baby, I'll treat you right, and I love you like I should have loved you all the time. Again, there's that pause. I love that.
I remember when I held you.
building that tension. And that transition there with those like drum machine clap sounds, that cha cha, like that's super cool too, and that helps really accentuate that transition. And here we have like a stereo percussion thing going on. And that helps differentiate what he did in the earlier chorus to this one. So he's adding something new. Okay, I love what he does here melodically, because we've already heard this melody so many times now, and he starts to switch it up. So some things remain the same and some things are changing, and that helps maintain that consistency, but you're still taking it to a slightly different place. Here's what I mean. So right here. So he just, you know, riffs on it a little bit. But the out of time, that stays the same, but then for the where the main melody was, he just riffs a little bit, but then halfway through he does go back to the original motif. And then here he goes back. Actually, he does switch it up a bit there too. So well produced, but as you can hear, it's not like there's a ton of things going on. It's not like it's switching from like this instrument to that sound to this sound to that sound.
Don't you dare touch that dial.
Instead, what's happening is they're making the most of whoever produced this song, whether it was Tess Faye, or I know he's worked with some pretty major league producers, but they do a great job of taking a few key sounds and letting those sounds be the ones that drive the song, and then they bring them in and out at different times of the song. They're not always adding new and interesting stuff, because you want your song to have some type of a mood, right? Some type of like, oh, it's that song with that sound. Because if you have 20 different sounds, it starts to just sound like a combination of a bunch of different things without having any type of real focus. So this song is very focused, it's very clean, it has that cool 80s feel. You've got some like Michael Jackson style throwback vocals going on with Tess Faye, and yeah,
like
it's really cool.
Says,
and then the rest of it is just,
shame.
It's just that guy talking, so I think we can bypass that. So that is Out of Time by The Weeknd. It's a super cool song. This is, in my opinion, this is how pop music should be made. I think this is a great example of, if you want to make good pop music, study this type of track, Out of Time by The Weeknd, where it's minimal to an extent, but it's also very meticulously structured, and there's a lot of very precise placement of sounds and those slight little gaps from and transitions from section to section where you have that space to breathe, and then you've got the slight variation of the melody for the back half of the song to keep you interested and engaged, and it does all those things correctly, and it does all those things beautifully. So an amazing song if you're into pop, indie pop. Highly recommend studying The Weeknd's album Dawn FM that he recently released, and especially this song Out of Time. It's an amazing song. So thanks for watching. Let me know in the comments if you enjoyed this. Let me know which song you would like me to review next. And obviously the structure that I'm using for this is much more chill. It's much less rehearsed than my typical content is. So I just wanted like an outlet and a way to make some, one, selfishly make some easier content so I can upload more videos to YouTube, but also to give you guys just a different taste, something a bit more casual and a bit more on the like entertainment side of things instead of like getting into the weeds all the time. This is just more of a fun thing to do. So if you want me to keep making these bonus videos and adding them to my upload schedule, do let me know in the comments, as well as let me know which song you would like me to review next. So thank you so much for watching, my friend. I will see you next time.